And they're all in line. They're off in the Pegasus World Cup. And what a start for Mucho Gusto, who fires out to the early lead. And Diamond Oops has early speed as well. Bodie Express is three wide going into that turn. And then it's Tax in between horses. And moving on the outsider, Higher Power in company with Mr. Freeze, who's now bursting toward the front. And Mr. Freeze, with a bold early move, has established the lead onto the backstretch. In front by a length over Mucho Gusto. Then Bodie Express, Higher Power to the outside. That opening quarter mile is up in 23.79 seconds as they head onto the backstretch. Diamond Oops is back there running in fifth. Tack sixth on the outside. Then it's True Timber along the rail, followed by Seeking the Soul. Tenfold is second last, and War Story has been left behind to trail the field as they continue their run up the backstretch here. So it is front-running Mr. Freeze, who's on top by three-quarters of a length. Bodie Express on the outside runs along in second through a 47.48 half mile. And right in behind the leaders is Mucho Gusto, who's down at the rail with a half mile to go. And Higher Power is being ridden to go now on the outside. Diamond Oops is behind them running in fifth. Tack sixth on the outside. And then it's Tenfold around the far turn. Mr. Freeze is the leader. Bodie Express runs up alongside of him. Mucho Gusto travels well now. He's three wide and he's edging up toward the top two. Diamond Oops is fourth. Higher Power's under pressure. And here comes Mucho Gusto, and they're into the stretch, and Mucho Gusto has taken the lead. Mucho Gusto comes to the eighth pole, opening up to lead by four. And back into second is Mr. Freeze on the inside, then Bodie Express, Diamond Oops, War Story running on late. Mucho Gusto in the Pegasus World Cup. He won it by five lengths. Mr. Freeze was second, War Story was third, Diamond Oops finished fourth, and the final time was 1 minute 48.85 seconds.
Bob Baffert, Irad Ortiz Jr., Mucho Gusto in a landslide, guys.
You know, he almost broke too good because he was on the lead.
Exactly.
And then Bodie Express went up and challenged him. A really good decision by Irad Ortiz in the first turn to ease him back. The question was, would the horse allow him to do that? He did. The horse settled. He let a couple of horses lead the way. And then he tipped him out, turning for home. Really good decision by Irad Ortiz, but the horse was phenomenal in accepting all of these different things for him.
You just saw Jimmy Barnes, Bob Baffert's assistant, the assistant to the stars, who is so well known with American Pharoah sweeping the Triple Crown on the road all the time with Baffert's horses. The grade one couch pays off again for Bob Baffert. But yeah, I mean, this horse had to be finessed. They did not want him on the early lead, and he beat the gate. All of a sudden, he's a length and a half in front. And you got to figure out a way to get him back. They probably didn't want him down on the inside.
No, because
horses.
Typically he's best outside.
Exactly.
Horses in the clear. So really a great race and performance by a horse with all the elements of the race different than what he's used to. Coming down the stretch here, he's in full command. Nobody's going to run in it. Bodie Express hung in there really well. And of course, Mr. Freeze hung in there pretty well himself.
A very disappointing performance for Higher Power, who was completely out of gas by the time they hit the top of the stretch and wound up crossing the finish line last of the starters. So hopefully he's okay.
Mr. Freeze in the mix there with War Story as well. But it is Mucho Gusto with the win. Let's get it down to Nick.
And I'm with Jimmy Barnes, the assistant trainer, the well-known assistant trainer to Bob Baffert. Jimmy, congratulations. You just said to me, I do all my best work by myself. Mr. Baffert will be very pleased. Have you spoken to him?
Not yet, but I will be talking to him soon.
And this horse has clearly settled into Florida well. Could you have expected a performance of that dominance?
Absolutely. You know, this horse was a fresh horse and he'd been training outstanding. So we were expecting a big performance today.
And when the two horses came out on Thursday, that could only have increased your confidence.
Well, it did increase us, and we moved in two post positions, so yeah.
This horse has been brought here, in a sense, to prepare for the $20 million race in Saudi Arabia. Is he a tough enough horse to take this and that in 6 weeks?
Absolutely. We'll go home and reevaluate the situation, but I see no reason why he couldn't.
So we could be looking at a horse now for 2020 who can string together several grade one races.
Hopefully he will.
Jimmy, congratulations. Well done.
Thank you.
What an emphatic victory by Mucho Gusto in the $3 million Pegasus World Cup and for the trophy presentation to His Royal Highness, who obviously is not here today, but I'm sure very thrilled by that victory. Prince Faisal bin Khaled, and accepting the award on behalf of Jill and Bob Baffert is Zan Wilson. For the chairman and president of the Stronach Group, Belinda Stronach, will you do us the honors, please? Gorgeous trophy there, and of course the Pegasus World Cup rings. And while I get to that, Irad, we haven't had the moment to speak with you. It's one thing watching how a race unfolds. Just tell me, for you, coming around that final turn, how much you knew you had to get such a powerful victory.
He was going very, very good the whole race, and by the triple, I start working on him. He gets some time to start going, but as soon as he take off, he start picking up the pace, and he just take off going to the quadruple, and he explode.
Appears you made the right decision.
Thanks, my agent, and thanks. I want to thank Bob Buffer for letting me ride the horse. And
Congratulations to all the connections here. There's a lot to like about Mucho Gusto. Congratulations to His Royal Highness Prince Faisal bin Khaled, Irad Ortiz, and of course, Bob Baffert.